The problem with water storage in the high desert is it gets contaminated. Mosquitoes, all kinds of bad things can happen to your water storage. And this is how I prevent that from happening. Just about every time that I make a video about water storage, someone comments that there's either no way to keep mosquitoes at bay or how do you keep mosquitoes at bay. And someone else will comment that the water gets stagnant. Even in a cistern, people think that the water is just going to go bad. So let me talk about why it might and why it might not, and how you can prevent it altogether. I have an aquaponic system here that's running about 600 gallons of water on average continuously. And when I first set this system up, I didn't have everything running. And after quite some time, one day, there were some mosquito larvae in one of these tanks here. So what happened is a mama mosquito found some water that she figured would be good for putting her kids in, you know, to make more mosquitoes. And the reason that they would do that is because there's not enough movement in the water. The way I fixed that is I used a net like this that probably didn't have holes in it, and I scooped out all that larvae and got rid of it. And then I connected this air pump, and that it's a bubbler, and it just ran bubbles, and the water, just the bubbler is enough to keep larvae from being laid. Since then, I've increased the size of my pump, and I have, I think it's 1600 gallons an hour running through this thing, and that's enough. What happens is this water level lowers about 4 or 5 inches, raises 4 or 5 inches about every 15 minutes. And that's just too much movement for mosquito larvae to be laid and hatch in a system like this. They would just die. They basically will drown. So you can see the bell siphon is just getting going. It'll actually pour much harder than that as it picks up. You can see there's bluegill down here. I just fed them some food. There's about 20 in there. So of course you can also reduce mosquitoes with the fish. The frogs that come to my ponds, seriously, hundreds or thousands of frogs come during monsoon season. They reduce mosquitoes. There's lots of fruit bats out here. They wipe them out. And so the truth is I've really only seen like 3 mosquitoes in my life out here. And then the larvae that I wiped out because I just kept looking. So larvae are not going to be laid in there ever again because I prevented it. Now, I do have a pond out here, and it hadn't had a pump on it at all, and there were never larvae laid in it. I think it's because there's not that many out here anyway. There are a lot of insects in there, and frogs in there, and birds that come and go. However, the point is to keep mosquitoes at bay, all you got to do is run a pump. So now I have a huge pump that, once this pond fills again, I'm going to get it in there and running. And I'm also going to build shade coverage to prevent algae growth there. Now, water storage in cisterns is really another story. So I have some basic IBC totes set up here for harvesting rain off of this side of my shop. And they're closed off enough that mosquitoes just will never get in there. And that's the same design that my cisterns have. So this is a cistern that's 16 feet long, 5 feet wide, 5 feet deep. That holds about 3,600 gallons of water. And I've been running a pump out of this one, so the lid's a little cracked. But still, I've never had anything other than maybe a little bit of dirt and maybe the occasional insect fall down. And that's just not a problem. And you filter the water when you're going to drink it anyway. I've never had mosquitoes in any of my cisterns, and it's because there's a closed system. So you don't have to run a bubbler in that water, and that water doesn't get gross. Water out where biology can interact with it, the sun and insects and so on and so forth, that can get stagnant, and then the breeding ground for stuff, that can get nasty. But the water in the cisterns isn't going to go bad. And if you just add a little bit of bleach, you're going to kill off bacteria and virus. And then when you filter the water, that pulls out other impurities and 99.999% of that chlorine you put in. The only other concern at that point is mice or pests getting down into the water, right? And so you need to put screens over your gutters so that can't happen. And you keep the bottom part here sealed off and that can't happen. And therefore you don't have any mice or pests. And of course, even if something tiny slipped through the system, you're killing bacteria and virus with the bleach, and then you're filtering the water completely. So you can see down in the cistern here, all I did was dug the hole we spoke about, lined it with a billboard liner. You can buy used billboard tarps and then just inspect them. And if they don't have holes in them, which is largely my experience, you can line a cistern with it. But I think it's almost just as cheap to buy pond liners now on Amazon and whatnot. So you could go ahead and do that. Line a hole. And instead of paying, an example, like a 3,000-gallon cistern is $3,000. So it was $200 to buy enough billboard liners to line two 3,600-gallon cisterns and a 4,500-gallon pond. Go get my free ultimate guide to off-grid living. I'll drop a link down below. Did you guys know I've written a couple bestsellers? And you can get that kind of information for free. It's a very in-depth guide on my website. And then if you love it, you can go buy my ebooks and courses as well. Oh, and as you can see, it's just crystal clear down there. There's sediment, a little bit of dirt stuff down there, but nothing that would harm you. And the water is crystal clear on top of it. So the demi-loons that are down the driveway, they just soak the water up, and so they don't hold water to cause any problems. And same with the reservoir out here on the pasture. Until the horses stomp it down and play in it enough, it's not going to hold water. It holds water for a few days and then just is all absorbed into the ground, which is good for the land. And you can see that these demi-loons clearly hold water, and that's why there's a lot more foliage in and around them. I've used as much as 400 gallons a week on my homestead and decided to dial that back. I'm at about 275 gallons a week. So if I had dug myself 40,000 gallons worth of rainwater storing area, if I made basically 10 of those cisterns, I could hold 40,000 gallons of water, and that would be enough to run the homestead for 3 years. And it's just never been a drought, you know, it's never been a drought that long, so you'd be pretty sufficient for quite some time. Surface areas like this are great for harvesting water off of. I haven't even set one up on the cabin yet because I just built it. The roof on the greenhouse slopes back to the garden, so it dumps water in the garden. And this is my little agricultural shed. There's another cistern behind it. So those harvests, that's a lot of surface area, but the demi-loons and the ditches, they run all the way through the first gate and to the corner gate at the corner of the property. And so that all directs water. Their water goes down that side of the driveway, and water just cascades down this side of the driveway, right? This is an enormous rain harvesting surface, and it's all directed to come right here and dump into my pond. That's 4,500 gallons, and it'll fill in an hour when it rains hard. In fact, it hasn't really rained hard, and about 1,000 gallons got dumped into it the other day. A lot of people told me that this would just evaporate, and it really doesn't. Even being open like it's always been, when this pond fills, it stays full either all the way through the rest of the year. It might dry up just before the next summer, or it'll make it all the way through with just being filled once. But I think the reason it dried up this time is because I used so much water for all the footings. I got 20 footings for the cabin, and I used only water from here to do that. The land was pretty well flat when I moved in here, and I've contoured my land to hold water. So you can see how much greener it is in these areas that I've contoured, and they're around the pond. And it takes a long time, but I've never watered any of this. It just keeps growing.
I guess one last thing to consider is you can have a water tower like this. Someone asked me just the other day, why is it so high? And they thought that it was just for aesthetics. But I would never do that just for the look of it, although it does look cool. It's at 20 feet height, roughly, which is about, how could I say? That's the point where you reach your maximum amount of pressure. Before, you have to be much, much higher to receive a small increase, if that makes sense. So about 20 feet is where you're going to get basically the most amount of pressure for the cost of doing it, you know? If you went 10 feet higher, it'd barely increase it at all.
And the benefit to having the tower is that, well, I've got electricity today and everything's fine, right? So pump water up to the tower. And then if anything ever goes wrong, I've got a week's supply of water that's already under pressure that can be directed anywhere on the homestead. And if you look at any small town, city, they've got a similar system like that. So all the livestock, the gardens, they're perfectly fine with the water the way it is. And then the final step is, for me, I just come out here. This is just pure rainwater, which is pretty well perfect anyway. And then I go dump it into my Berkey-styled water filter in there from Membrane Solutions. And I filter my water. I put about 3 gallons in there per day. Just filter and drink water. And that's the entire loop for my water storage here on my high desert homestead.